Finnemore's Souvenir Programme.
Well, here we are. Bon appetit.
Oh, gosh, thank you. It looks lovely.
Well, wait till you taste it.
Yeah, it's delicious. Really stupid question, sorry. What is it?
It's a lasagna, obviously.
Oh, yeah, lasagna, of course. Is it a special recipe?
No, it's just a straightforward lasagna. I mean, I had to make a couple of substitutions, but basically...
What sort of...?
Well, it's veggie, obviously, so instead of beef ragout, I used fruit. Yeah, I know it sounds odd, but actually, if you get red fruits and berries and you just boil them down and down and you get a bit of sugar to bind it together, it kind of works.
Uh-huh. And the white sauce?
Yeah, that's just a standard bechamel sauce, you know, butter, flour, milk. Oh, except I used up all the flour on the pasta, so I just used icing sugar instead.
Is that the same?
More or less.
Right, and when you say... pasta?
Yep, homemade pasta sheets.
Any special...
No, just the usual. Flour, eggs, butter.
Sugar?
Yeah, I do put a bit of sugar. Most people don't notice.
Yeah, I did notice. So, do you have a pasta machine?
No, I find you don't need one. I just mix it all together and then stick it straight in the oven. That way it rises a little bit and you get these nice thick pasta sheets, which you can then layer with the fruit ragout and the sweet bechamel and, hey presto, lasagna.
It's a cake.
No, a lasagna.
It's a Victoria sponge. Quite a nice one.
Nonsense.
So this bet of yours that you could go a year without cake.
Without cake? Yeah, not without lasagna. No one said that.
Just how much lasagna are you eating?
Not much. No. I'll make one at the beginning of the week and then I'll have a piece most days. Or if I'm on the go, I'll just have a couple of pork pies. Mm.
Veggie pork pies?
Of course.
Sugar instead of pork, quite flat, good for dunking in tea.
Shut up.
Noah?
Oh, hello, love. Hello, Japhet. Look, almost finished.
Yeah, very nice. No, we've got some bad news. Jaff and I have been doing some sums and... well, I'll just say it. We're going to need two arcs.
What? No. No, I've been over the measurements God gave me. They are exactly right, as you would expect.
Yeah, when we set off.
What do you mean?
Well... we're keeping the animals in twos. For a voyage of unknown length.
Yeah?
Dad, do you know the average gestation period of an opossum?
Let's pretend I don't.
12 days.
Oh.
After which she gives birth to a litter of 20.
Yeah, so we've run the numbers, and basically within 3 weeks, the ark will sink under the weight of opossums alone.
The opossoclipse.
Dad, can we talk to you?
Yeah, in a minute, boys. I'm just...
No, it is important. We're going to need two arcs.
Yeah, your mum's already told me. One for the males, one for the females.
Oh.
What?
No, that wasn't... I mean, it's a good point, but...
We were thinking one for predators, one for prey.
We're going to need three arcs.
Yeah.
No, actually...
What?
Four?
Oh, yes. Four arcs.
Oh, no, hang about. Can't we just put the male prey animals with the female predator? No. Ignore me.
No, you're right. Four is the minimum, isn't it? To be sure no one breeds and no one eats anyone.
Yeah. Oh, no, although...
What?
If the predator animals don't eat the prey animals...
Yeah?
Well, what do they eat?
Five arcs.
Five?
Yeah. The fifth filled with extra prey animals.
Ooh. I tell you what, though, during boarding, we're going to have to be careful not to tell them which arc that is.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Hang on. No, it's okay.
Yeah?
We can do it with three.
Really?
Yeah. We combine the male and female prey arcs again, let them do their thing, and then, you know, problem solves itself.
Okay, Right, how would the meals get to the predator arcs?
Well, I suppose we'd have to ferry them over.
Okay. Only the thing is, God's picked us to save because apparently we're the only nice humans left on Earth. I don't know, I'm just not sure that sits well with encouraging half the animals to breed and then ferrying off their children to feed to the lions.
Yeah, so what do you suggest?
Okay, suppose we go back to just one arc, right? And then, in a greatest good for the greatest number sort of way, what we could do is, every time we run out of meat for the carnivores, we slaughter the biggest animal currently on the ark, yeah? Thus, providing the largest possible amount of meat and freeing up the largest possible amount of space for the new arrivals. I mean, it's tough on the big guys, but it beats the death berries.
And in conclusion, Your Holiness, that is how I square a literal reading of Genesis with the extinction of the dinosaurs.
Sir, are you the one they call Snetterton?
That I am, my boy.
Sir, I have walked 70 miles in 3 days to see you. They say that you are the finest craftsman of musical instruments in the world.
Oh, now, I shouldn't go so far as that. Stradivarius is very good.
He is nothing to you, sir. I have come to ask, will you fulfill the dream of my life and take me on as your apprentice?
Oh, I don't know, boy. Some things can't be taught.
Then might I at least be allowed to watch the master at work?
Well, perhaps there's no harm in that. Watch, then. First, I take the tempered metal bar. Then I bend it, thus and thus. Then I tie a bit of string to it, and 'tis done.
A masterpiece. Oh,
well, perhaps. History will judge.
May I try?
I admire your spirit, my boy, very well. So, take the bar, and bend, and bend, and tie, and... Well, now. 'Tis a weak, callow effort, but there is promise there. You have raw talent, my boy, but only tireless practice will make it pay. Try again. Bend, and tie, and... Not bad.
Truly?
Not bad at all. A fine, workmanlike instrument of which no triangulist need be ashamed. Again, bend, and tie, and... My boy, your tireless dedication has paid off. This latest piece, why only an expert could tell it from one of my own.
You do me too much honor.
Oh, by no means. Again, bend, and tie, and... I have no words. This triangle is the finest triangle I have ever seen. Truly, the pupil has surpassed the master.
No. Do not say so.
What is true?
Well, sir, if it is true, which I do not grant, it is only because of your selfless encouragement and teaching you have given to me over the last 3 minutes.
Your words move me deeply. To work with you and observe the flowering of your talent has truly been one of the greatest experiences of my morning. Now then, let's do 200 more and knock off for lunch.
Queen Leader of Sparta. Greetings, mortal.
Who said that?
I did. I said it.
Who?
Me. Down here.
Oh! Oh! Hello. Aren't you clever?
I'm not clever. Well, I am clever, but more importantly, I am Zeus, king of the gods.
Are you?
Well, of course I am. Who did you think I was?
Well...
Oh, yes, okay, a swan. Obviously a swan. But who else did you think had taken on the form of a swan?
I hadn't really got that far, to be honest. I was just enjoying the talking swan.
Well, it's me anyway, Zeus, king of the gods.
All right. Hello. What do you want?
Well... Isn't it obvious?
No.
You're a woman. I'm a swan. What do you think I want?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.